few words before each piece, or kind of introduce them a little bit. My first piece requires not much introduction, just a little warm-up. It's a Chopin Nocturne. It's Opus 55, number 1 in F minor, to be exact. So, hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Some of the softer and more lyrical sounds that the organ is able to make, but that it's often not associated with. And then after that, I'll play the Little Fugue in G minor by the unrivaled king of organ music, Johann Sebastian Bach. Enjoy.
Thank you. Is it?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, great. Yeah. The next pieces I'm going to play on the piano are solo piano compositions by myself. The first one is a mazurka whose origin has to do with a certain virtuoso pianist named Jan Nisecki. You've heard of him. I have been following him for many years because he's the same age as me and I find him quite an inspiration as a young musician. I attended his Roy Thompson Hall debut when he was 16. And in about 2015, I think, I went to a concert of his, or I was going to a concert of his, and I had the idea to write a short piano composition for him as a token of my appreciation and sort of reverence for him. Although I only really committed to that idea about 24 hours before the concert, so this piece was written in 24 hours. And it's a mazurka, which of course is homage to Chopin, being sort of the king of the mazurka, popularized the mazurka. Jan Nisecki loves to play Chopin. He's known for his performances of Chopin. And also to Lisecki's Polish heritage, because it's a Polish dance. I didn't mention that. And then the next piece I'm going to play is Theme and Variations on a Theme by Beethoven. And Theme and Variations is a very old musical tradition that dates back to the Renaissance of a composer essentially taking the melody or musical idea of another composer and embellishing it, developing it into these sets of variations. In the classical period, it had a very improvisatory tradition where composers would be given a theme and expected to improvise on it on the spot. I won't be doing that today. This is a very pre-composed set of variations on the second movement theme from Beethoven's Seventh Symphony. Hope you enjoy it. With that piece, you'll hear the theme in its entirety played at the beginning and then it moves into the variations. So this is mazurka followed by my theme and variations on the theme of Beethoven. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ciao!
German composer and organist, but his career as a concert organist greatly overshadowed his work as a composer, and so we very rarely hear any of his music. And this particular piece I found on a school trip to Germany in a tiny little music store in a little city in Germany, because they were having a book sale, so I just decided to go through the discount music, and I stumbled upon this piece and ended up falling in love with it, so I hope you enjoy it as much as I do.
Thank you. Thank you. who's a power couple, the composer Robert Schumann and his wife Clara Schumann. Clara was more famous in her time as a pianist. She was actually a better pianist than Robert Schumann, but she is also quite an excellent composer. Yes, so the first piece is by Robert Schumann, and it is about longing for the woods, so longing to return to the woods, Sehnsucht nach der Waldgegend. And it sort of fits into a broader theme of longing for the homeland that characterized a lot of German music of the time. And actually, art song in German music, French music, Italian music was all used to sort of convey a sense of national pride at this time. And so once we're led into the woods by Robert Schumann, Clara Schumann introduces us to a new character, Die Lorelei. The Lorelei is a very popular figure in German lore. She's a sort of a femme fatale. She is, in this case, a mermaid who lures men to their death through her song. And actually, both Robert and Clara wrote a piece about Die Lorelei, but Robert Schumann's piece about Die Lorelei is much more beautiful and charming, very legato, smooth, and Clara takes a very different approach. You can definitely hear that this Lorelei is very dangerous. She's a lot more similar to, if any of you know, Schubert's Erlkönig. It kind of sounds like that. So I hope you enjoy these two.
Lebt mich umfangen, by Nikolaus Bruns, who is a 17th century German organist and composer. And in his day, he was seen pretty much as the leading figure in organ music until Bach came around. But this particular piece I find interesting because of the balance between sections that are very clearly composed in forms that were familiar to people of the time, such as fugues. But then there's also a lot of more loosely composed sections that are almost sound more improvisatory, which I think makes for a engaging piece, so I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
is called A Lullaby, which is a setting of a beautiful poem by Eugene Field. And I wrote this piece for my sister for a recital last year. And the form of this poem is in three stanzas. And so I tried to imitate that in my piece, which is in three sections. And in the first section, it shows a mother trying to put her child to sleep. And then in the second part of the poem is what I'm interpreting as the lyrics to the song that she sings her child to put him to sleep. And then the third stanza takes a sort of dark and sad twist, where the mother is reminiscing on a child that she used to sing the same lullaby to, but that has now passed on. And she presents the image of angels protecting the child's grave through the night, which is a beautiful way to end.
Thank you.
University of Toronto. It is a setting of the very famous E.E. Cummings poem, I Carry Your Heart With Me. Rather than try and ad lib some explanation, I'll just read my own program notes that I wrote. Touching proclamation, I carry your heart with me, may sit in many different emotional contexts. Compassion, grief, love, all of which seem to coexist in Cummings' nuanced text, forming a new complex affect of their own. In this art song setting, I strove to capture that affect, multifaceted and bittersweet, though ultimately rooted in a sense of tender affection. This is I Carry Your Heart With Me.
Thank you.
So we'd like to just finish off this afternoon with a little surprise. It is a trio of us singing, even though Claire is the real singer here. As it so happens, we all met each other in some way or another related to singing. I met Nicholas in the Bach Chamber Youth Choir several years ago, and Claire in a vocal octet that we formed at school. That is actually, we are the three members of that 8-person octet. Although even though we are that small number, we will still present a small piece for you, a sort of rare Beethoven song titled Abschiedsgesang, farewell song. Most likely written for the farewell party of some nobility about 200 years ago. As the lyrics say in German, the hour strikes, we must depart. It describes, or it cautions the person who's going away that if their friends come to visit, they should bake them a cake and serve them coffee and wine. And then at the end, of course, Leopold, goodbye dear friend, live well. Thank you so much again for Jubilee United Church. Thank you to Ed and Charlie and the committee, and thank you for having us, and thank you for coming, and hope you had a wonderful time.
Stille Freude, erringst du dir. Your talent to Jubilee. We appreciate it. It was a grand performance.